हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग ऑनलाइन क्लासेस।
द सेंट्रीफ्यूगल गवर्नर्स आर बेस्ड ऑन द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ बैलेंसिंग ऑफ सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स ऑन द रोटेटिंग बॉल्स बाय एन इक्वल एंड ऑपोजिट फोर्स व्हिच इज कॉल्ड एज कंट्रोलिंग फोर्स। द सेंट्रीफ्यूगल गवर्नर कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू बॉल्स ऑफ इक्वल मास, दीज आर कॉल्ड द फ्लाई बॉल्स व्हिच आर अटैच्ड टू द गवर्नर आर्म्स एज कैन बी सीन। These yellow ones are the fly balls and the blue arms are the governor arms. These balls along with the spindle will rotate as the spindle is driven by the engine by means of bevel gears. As the engine shaft rotates, the bevel gears also rotate, and along with them the spindle will rotate. And since the arms are attached to spindle by pin joint, the arms will also rotate about the shaft or the spindle axis. The arms are connected to links. These green color ones are called the links. So these links are attached to a sleeve which will revolve with the spindle. But this sleeve can also move, slide up and down along the spindle axis. So as the fly balls and sleeve raise up with the increase in spindle speed, they will fall down with the decrease in spindle speed. So as the speed of the spindle increases, the fly balls will raise up, taking the sleeve also upward and vice versa. In order to control the movement of sleeve, there are two stoppers provided. These pink ones are the stoppers. So the limit of travel of sleeve is controlled by the location of these two stoppers. This sleeve is connected to a throttle valve using a bell crank lever. This throttle valve is used to control the supply of working fluid. The simplest form of centrifugal governor is vat governor. So let us see how it works. When the load on engine is increasing, the speed of engine and thereby the governor decreases. So due to this, the centrifugal force on the fly balls will decrease, which will move the fly balls inward, that is downward. And the sleeve also will move downward. So this downward movement of sleeve will operate the throttle valve through a bell crank lever to increase the supply of working fluid, and therefore due to the increased load on engine, as the speed of engine has decreased, now because of this increase in supply of the working fluid, the engine speed also increases. So this way the governor controls the supply of working fluid and keeps the speed of the engine within certain limits. That means the governor will maintain a constant mean speed of the engine within prescribed limits. So similarly, when the load on the engine decreases, then the speed of engine and also the governor increases. Due to this increase in speed, the centrifugal force on the fly balls also will increase, which will move the fly balls outward and upward, and hence the sleeve also will move upward. This upward movement of sleeve will operate the throttle valve again through the same bell crank lever, and due to that the throttle valve is operated such a way that the supply of working fluid will decrease, and therefore the engine speed also will come down to mean speed again. So governor is a device which is used to maintain a constant speed of the engine. So if the load on engine increases, the speed of engine will decrease below the mean speed of the engine. So this governor will help maintain the average speed of the engine. So in case the load is decreasing, then the engine speed is increased, so that higher speed is again brought down to mean speed. So whether the load on engine is varying or not, the governor will take care of the mean speed of engine, such that the mean speed of engine is always maintained. So let us see some important terms related to governors. So this is the governor, these are the fly balls, this is the sleeve, and these arms, governor arms, are pivoted at O. So these arms can be connected in different ways. So here they are connected at this particular position and the rotation will happen. So this is the axis of rotation. So in this particular case, these arms have crossed each other and they are meeting, they are connected at some other fixed end. The height of the governor is the vertical distance from the center of the ball mass to the point of intersection of the arms. So in all the three cases, the point of intersection of the arms with the spindle axis is O. So these arms are intersecting at O and the intersection is happening on the spindle axis. So these three lines are meeting at O. So from the center of ball mass to this point of intersection O is the height of the governor, denoted by H. And the horizontal distance from the axis of rotation to the center of ball mass at any speed is the radius of rotation. So this is R, which is the radius of rotation. So the height of the governor is the vertical distance and the radius of rotation is the horizontal distance from the axis of rotation to the center of ball mass at any speed. This is denoted by R. Equilibrium speed is the speed at which the governor balls, arms and sleeve, and all naturally the links, because these are all connected. So these should be in complete equilibrium and the sleeve does not move up or down. So when the sleeve is for a given speed, when the sleeve is not sliding, so that speed is called as equilibrium speed. And the speed at the mean position of the balls or the sleeve is called the mean equilibrium speed. The speed at maximum radius of rotation is the maximum equilibrium speed, means the speed is highest and as the balls are rotating, they are at the highest possible height. So as the speed increases, the balls will raise up, the sleeve also will move up. So the radius, so that time the radius of rotation will be maximum. So when the radius of rotation is at maximum value, the speed at that particular point is called maximum equilibrium speed. And when the speed of the engine is very low, that time these balls will be sliding down and the sleeve also will come down. So that minimum radius, so at that minimum radius, the equilibrium speed is called as minimum equilibrium speed. And as we have discussed, there will be stops that will be provided up above and below the mean position of sleeve, so as to control the vertical displacement of the sleeve. So that vertical distance that is traveled by the sleeve due to change in the equilibrium speed is called as sleeve lift. So as the speed changes, how much the balls will raise up or down will change, means the height of the governor changes. So let us try to derive a relation between the speed of the engine with respect to the height of the governor. So let M be the mass of each ball taken in kilogram, then weight may be taken in Newton, which is MgW. The tension in arms is T, measured in Newtons, and let omega be the angular velocity of the arms, balls about the spindle axis, measured in radian per second. Then as we have already seen, R is the horizontal distance between the center of ball and spindle axis, which is the radius of rotation. And we know height of the governor is measured in meter and it is denoted as H. So R is also taken in meter. So FC is a centrifugal force that is acting on the ball, so which can be given as MR omega square. So here, as the rotation happens, So these balls are actually, when the speed is increasing, these balls are actually raising up because of the centrifugal force. As omega increases, the centrifugal force increases, because centrifugal force is given as mr omega square. So as the speed increases, the centrifugal force increases, and due to that centrifugal force, the balls will be moving away, outward. So in case omega is less, then the centrifugal, this magnitude also will come down, due to which these will be moving inward. Inward means towards the axis of rotation. The ball is in equilibrium under the action of different forces. One force is the very weight of the ball. We have assumed weight to be W. So W is equal to mg. So this is mg, which is shown here also. And as the rotation is happening, the centrifugal force will act outward and radially. So the centrifugal force is Fc, which is nothing but mr omega square. And there is also tension. If at all we are taking the FBD of the ball, the tension will be away. So from, if the FBD of point O is taken, then here the tension will be away from O. So these are the three forces that are acting at the ball, and the ball should be in equilibrium under the action of all these forces. Because the ball will be in equilibrium, we know that under equilibrium conditions, sum of moments acting about any point is zero. Now that we are measuring all the dimensions, say h, r, with respect to this axis of spindle, and with respect to O, O is, we know the all the dimensions from O. So let us take sum of moments about O. So that will be zero. Let us make a convention. For us, let the clockwise moment be positive and anti-clockwise moment be negative. So in that case, if C is making a clockwise moment about O, and the value of moment of FC about O is FC into this perpendicular distance between O and FC is H. So FC into H. And MG, the moment of weight of ball about O is making a anti-clockwise moment. So that is negative, minus MG into the perpendicular distance between the line of action of MG and O is R. This is R. So the moment is MG into R. And the other force is T, which is passing through O. So it is passing through O, so the moment of T about O will be zero. T into the perpendicular distance, the distance of T and O is zero. So therefore it will be plus or minus zero is equal to this zero. So we are left with FCH is equal to MGR. And we also know that FC is nothing but mr omega square. This is h is equal to mgr. We can cancel out m and m here, then r and r also can be cancelled out. So all we are left with is h is equal to g divided by omega square. So we have finally derived an equation, a relation between height of the governor and the speed of the engine. So let us try to simplify it further. G is nothing but 9.81 meter per second square divided by, we also know that omega is equal to 2 pi n by 60. So on substituting omega as 2 pi n by 60, we will get 9.81 into the 60 square can be taken to this numerator, becomes 60 square divided by 2 pi whole square and n square. As we can see, 9.81 into 60 square by 2 pi whole square is a constant. So if we calculate this, it comes out to be 895 divided by n square. So h is equal to 895 by n square is the relation between height of the governor and RPM of the engine. So here completes our derivation. So from the obtained relation h is equal to 895 by n square, it's clear that the height of governor, that is h, is inversely proportional to n square. So at such speeds, the value of h corresponding to a small change in speed is not enough to operate the mechanism to give the necessary change in fuel supply. So this means that in this type of governor, the movement of sleeve is very less at high speeds. And therefore, this type of governor is not suitable for high speeds, or the governor will work satisfactorily only at speeds between 60 to 80 rpm. To overcome this drawback, the governor may be loaded with a dead weight or by means of a spring.
Thanks for watching. If this video was of help to you, please like it and share it with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel.